Hello. I'd like to tell you a story about market push versus market pull. If I pushed you tomorrow to apply at NASA, what would you say? I'd figure 10 to 25% of you might say, sure, I have something to offer them. I'm going to do that. 50% of you might say, nah, I don't really have anything to offer NASA, I'm not going to. 10% might say, I don't want to even apply there. And those doing the math, 15% of you are undecided. I've been privileged to work in the high-tech business for 22 years. I was part of two startup companies that were acquired 3 times. Yes, one of them was acquired twice. What did I know about biodefense? Creating, producing, and selling air sampling equipment to first responders. What did I know about the biomedical field and working with cancer and pharmaceutical research companies? Well, I was at the right place at the right time. I pushed myself to use my business background to go into a new industry. I pushed myself further. I pushed myself for new experiences. I pushed myself for new positions. And then the pull happened, the pull from the companies, the pull to do more, the pull to fill positions, the pull to take a company from its current level to a new higher level. Never stop looking for that pull. It's always out there, even if it's outside your own company. In the first company, it was around 9/11 when the anthrax letters were being sent through the U.S. Postal Service. I was coming out of a background of construction, hospitality, and small business operations. I knew assembly, supply chain, customer service, and administration. I had no idea about anthrax or any of the other biological threats, nor did I know how to sell to governments, municipalities, or first responders. But I learned, and I learned quickly. We introduced a handheld air sampling device that first responders would use to go into an area to take an air sample to detect biological threats in a liquid form. It was interesting to see how they came back to us. They were looking for different features, different uses, different environments. They were looking for ease of use, reduction of cross-contamination, and continuous air sampling for real-time biodetection. What we pushed into the market was a proof of concept. What they pulled back was ideas for greater features to make our instrument better. In the second and current company of Sartorius, I didn't know that cancer and pharmaceutical companies used a library of 2 million drug compounds to possibly come up with 10,000 ideas and take that from 1 to 5 drug research, clinical trials, certification, and sales to the market. Picture a lab technician taking a sample and putting it on a slide, then looking at the slide underneath a microscope, writing down the data. Our instrument is so fast it'll make your head spin. Now picture that same technician doing 96 samples in 5 minutes, 384 samples in 15 minutes. That's the type of speed I'm talking about. We have a customer in the Bay Area that works with clients that have cancer and a very short time to live. They're trying to personalize their treatment by taking a sample of their blood and comparing it to the compounds of the cancer drug. That way they can specialize their treatment based on the best reaction that they have. They came to us and said, we want to return your instrument. It's clogging. We can't help our clients and they're losing hope. For Sartorius, it would have been a $250,000 loss. But for their clients, it was a loss of hope. So we took that market pull and we discovered a new buffer that would help the machine work better and prevent those clogs and keep the research going. What is your current market pull right now? How is your company dealing with the chip shortage? How is your company dealing with the supply chain back up. What are you doing about the worldwide government strife and hardship? Is your supply chain not there and costs more? What are your solutions? A few years ago, we felt the push to consolidate our operations in North America, to increase efficiencies, to reduce complexities, to simplify process, and to centralize our operations. We felt the pull from Ann Arbor. We share a common core value of sustainability. It's an attractive place to live, a strong workforce, and multiple high-tech universities that we can partner and collaborate with. Our current push is to build our flagship building here and use our leadership in energy and environment design, also known as LEED, solar panels, electronic vehicle charging stations, and our own internal company push for carbon neutral. So I can imagine up to this point, you've been doing the market push, getting the jobs so you can have a better resume, obtaining the higher level education, and checking the boxes to make things work. Take a look where the market pull is. Take yourself, give them what they want. Solve their problems, fill their needs. Now back to my original question. If I asked you to apply at NASA, would you? Better yet, if I pulled you to Sartorius, would you? It's about your skills, your experience, your education. It's about your knowledge and how you can help Sartorius. Thank you.